If there is one golden rule that every country must keep in mind, would be to consider education as a basic human right and to ensure the continuation of education for all through safe distance learning during this global COVID-19 crisis, no matter how each country varies in terms of ICT infrastructure, teaching and learning capabilities, economy, geographical condition, education system, and so on, there is one thing we all share together, that our schools are shut down and distance learning is the only option left to maintain this valuable human right of education for all. If this is the case, we have to find the best solution and strategy that fits for each country. From the South Korea case, the government has concentrated much of their effort to prevent school closures and promote online learning as a substitute. However, this is not without flaws, as some students still lack internet access or don't have a device capable of learning online. To address this issue, students without access to internet can get support from the government, both in internet installation, a monthly stipend for internet access, and can borrow digital devices from their schools and local education offices. Now, securing the ICT infrastructure and providing at least the minimum level of digital access to children, especially from low-income families, is vital. But the issue of money is always a problem. One way to tackle this is to work together and get support from the private sector, just like Korea did. Major telecommunications companies in Korea kindly agreed to take the social responsibility by temporarily offering free data access and to make donations of digital equipment.